The first of the 40 gallons is ready for fish. Let's do an update first.
So here we have it. So this is a 40 gallon. We scaped it and set it up in one video, built the filtration behind it. It's been running for a couple of weeks at this point. The video you saw originally was older than you think. Anyways, the plants are starting to melt, which is normal in a tank like this when the plants are just freshly moved. They got to adjust to the lighting and whatnot. But if we look closely, we can see just how badly it is in some of them. This happened originally when I added them to the 120 that we stole them from. We added them to the back and they all melted away. Next thing I know, I had three times as many of them, and we robbed that tank and put them all in here. This tank is doing quite well. I mean, really, I don't have to do anything to it. A couple water changes here and there, balanced the CO2 in here, made sure it was at the right levels, which we'll go over in a future video as well, and started to dose it a little bit. But one of the things we need to do before we add fish is make sure this filter is cycled, even though I did take some old filters from these tanks here and kind of squeeze them behind here, so a lot of the bacteria and stuff built up on here. We're gonna give it a little bit of a jump, a little jump start as well. Now to jump start it, we're using Fritz bacteria. A lot of you guys have seen this before. I use it all the time to jump start tanks and whatnot. This tiny little bottle is good enough for 50 gallons. I'm gonna put some in the front here. You'll see that it'll cloud up a little bit. Maybe half the bottle in the front, but most importantly, I like to put this where the actual filter is, so we'll be dumping it back here. Dumping it right on top and in sponge here, just like so. Did cloud the tank up slightly, but that's normal, it will clear up. Now we want to make sure that this bacteria is kept alive, so we got to add the fish.
What fish are we stocking it with, you might ask yourself? Well, I've been trying to hide these from you guys for a couple of months now. I got them in this bucket here and they're done, they're quarantined. I think it's the perfect fish for that tank. Let me know if you think so too.
A quick top view from here, can you guess what they are? I wonder if anybody actually can guess what these are from here. What about from here? What if we zoom in a little bit? That's gotta give it away. Little hummingbirds. That's what they look like, little hummingbirds.
I don't have a thing for real hummingbirds, but when it comes to fish, I like puffer fish are like a hummingbird, and I really like them for some reason lately.
Yeah, so the tank is a bit cloudy still, of course, just from adding in that bacteria. But one of the things that I know is that the water parameters in this aquarium versus every other aquarium are identical. I keep all of these tanks the same. They're the same temperature, same parameters, everything. So we'll add in the first little wave of these guys. In they go. More. You just want to move fast with puffer fish. Get them in and out. If you got to use a net, you'll have to use it. A lot of people will complain that you shouldn't use a net when netting a puffer fish because they puff up, but that rarely happens. Yeah, this is gonna look absolutely amazing. Let's give them a couple minutes to settle in. They already look better in this tank.
Yeah, so we're minutes into this, adding them in. Literally make 2-3 minutes, and I'm just noticing they're already coloring up. They'll be able to fatten up in this tank as well. In quarantine, they weren't fed as much, just to keep water quality pristine and focus on their overall health. But a few of them are actually quite chunky. We'll let these guys settle in for a while and see how they do long term. Now, one of the warnings I want to give you with the Amazon puffer, that's what these guys are, is Amazon puffers, and there's about 16 in this tank. They do really good in groups, but these guys gotta be one of the most difficult puffers to keep simply because they're picky eaters, they prefer live. It took me a while to get them onto pellets, but these guys will now eat whatever I tell them. As with all the fish in my gallery, you know, eventually I can get them onto prepared foods, but it can take a while. They're going to be incredibly, incredibly active. It's probably the most active puffer fish from based on my experience. But a lot of the times, well, I had figure eights and I had pea puffers a long, long time ago. But they're up there with being the most active. The fajaca, of course, just lays down. It's not very active. The saltwater puffers are far more active as well. Anyways, if you're thinking about getting these and you don't have a ton of experience in the hobby, you haven't been in it for too long, my advice would be to simply don't get them. Give it some time, give yourself some more time to gain some more experience, and then possibly consider them because, again, these guys can be incredibly finicky and sensitive to water quality. But once you do have these guys
nice and healthy in your aquarium. They're almost bulletproof. Fantastic fish. Look at them just flying around like a little hummingbird. I find that hilarious. That's exactly how they swim. Little hummingbirds. The other note about these guys is they actually get relatively big. And because I have 16 of them, they're going to grow out in here. But eventually we're going to move them to the 2,000 gallon where we're creating like the ultimate community tank.
Lights are out in this tank for the night, but as you can see, I do like puffers. I just think they're so cute and funny looking. This is a Stars and Stripes saltwater puffer. He's actually quite large. And then we have a big lazy Fajaca puffer over here. Not as active, does a lot of laying down, more of an ambush predator per se, but he's always got that big goofy smile on his face. This is Tyrese.
And this
is your boy Kevin.
Anyways, if you have a relatively large aquarium, like 40 gallons or larger, and you're looking for a really fun and entertaining fish, I'd suggest maybe trying out 3 to 5 puffer fish if you have some experience. These guys do get to around 3 inches long, so I would say they're like the medium-sized puffer. I wouldn't categorize them as like the dwarfs. We're spending a lot of time over here, but again, we just added them to the tank, and look how active they are. You know, healthy fish don't do this right off the bat. Just adding them in, but I definitely needed to add some fish in here just to feed these plants and get this tank going even more. I'll just have to watch it closely and do my water changes, but look at the patterns. Oh, just gorgeous. Little skinny, couple little skinny ones, couple little fat ones, but that happens. This will be they were quarantined in a 120 gallon tank. And it was much more difficult for them to find the food, so it'll be a lot easier in this one.
Anyways, those little puffers are really cute, and eventually we're going to do a video of feeding them, and I'll do like a care video of how to keep them and whatnot. And it's really cute when they eat. It's really funny. It's actually late here, so I'm a little tired, but these guys I think are going to do really well in this tank overall.
I think that you guys will agree that this was like the perfect fish for this tank. I know that some people want a gourami and whatnot, but you know, truth be told, I got the Amazon puffers because I knew we'd be putting it in a 40. I knew that a couple months ago, but, you know, it's fun to play the guessing game, but that doesn't mean I can't put gourami down there or over here or whatever. Well, I do have plans as well, but we'll see what happens. Anyways, Amazon puffers. Hope you like them. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you're not subscribed to my channel yet, make sure you do or you're going to miss them.